On August 26, it will be the primaries, and voters in different cities and counties are called to choose individuals to hold public office. To talk about the upcoming election from the Haitian perspective, we invited Michael Lenaghan, a professor of social sciences at Miami-Dade College, and Patrick Jabouin, founder and president of H.E.L.P for You, a civic engagement organization in Broward County. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
In the program. Well, for being very active in the community, you might call since 1992, working at Miami-Dade College and having different activities and political engagement activities with your students. How you have seen throughout the year the Haitian-American voters influencing the elections?
I think the perspective or lens I look through is through the eyes of years and experiences of the wonderful students that I serve, a growing number of which, and almost a majority of which at the present time, are from the Haitian American community. And it's my observation that, in a very positive and exciting way, the ultimate American experience is being demonstrated by our Haitian American brothers, sisters, neighbors, and in different communities. As you see the engagement, sometimes because of what doesn't work or what's new and finding out how to operate in a new country and environment and so on, and then advancement, people aspiring to office from within the community, and then also realizing that different candidates, be they Haitian American or not, have an inherent interest in serving and serving well the Haitian American community. And so over this last 20 plus year period, it's my observation that as more Haitian Americans have participated in voting and making themselves evident by enlightened special interest groups, not all special interest groups are bad, through professional, nursing, legal, and other groups, we've seen what I call the ultimate American experience, which is, again, bubbling up from a variety of different jobs, and then a variety of different political engagements, and then eventually elected office. And frankly, following what from the beginning of the Republic has been the engagement, if you will, enlivenment, and then uplifting influence in different political, economic, and social circumstances. But politically, it's only been recently that I've seen an awareness, the association between I've got to vote in the primaries, or I've got to vote, whether it's a candidate of my particular ethnicity or culture or someone else, if they're good on my issues, educational, economic, employment, rather than, oh, it's politics, or the country I came from wasn't that participatory, or other things we sometimes bring with us. I happen to be with a third generation Irish background, but all of us are immigrants. Even American Indians would tell you, who came from ultimately where we call China today. But the big question is engagement, enlightenment, and then enforcement, making the rules work for you, and then changing them by elective office if you don't.
And you, Patrick, you've been very involved in Broward County for a while now, and even in 2000, you were a candidate for a commission seat in the city of Sunrise.
Yes.
How you have seen this change throughout the year?
Well, the change as far as demographically, when you're looking at Broward County, that the demographic has changed, not only towards as far as Haitian, when you're looking at this is a county now that is a minority majority. So with the Haitians, with regards to the Haitian, as a Haitian American, when you're looking at any potential candidate, realize that the populations that they need to reach out to the different, to the various groups, as far as not just gender wise, but the ethnicities as well. So with the Haitians striving, and as you mentioned, as far as my candidacy, it just so happened when I did in the city of Sunrise, it was not just as a Haitian, because you look at the constituent as a whole, you're not just running just for one particular group, you're running for the people. And that city at that time did not have a large Haitian population. When you're looking at, then till now, we still don't have an elected Haitian American elected to any position in the county, in Broward County. But it is still growing because there are certain preparation that somewhere that it's not just that where you have any particular cities that you would have a majority of the population to be one particular ethnic group, because it's becoming more of a melting pot. So you have to more or less reach out to the various communities as well, and making sure that you're involved as far as the name recognition. Like I tell people constantly, that election is nothing but a popularity contest. But more or less to get into the contest, there's ways that for us making sure that your name gets out there. So with regards to, and as Michael mentioned before, that to get them engaged. So as far as my organization, what we do, not just politically, but is to get people engaged into the system, understanding as far as the economic, the educational process, as far as personal development. So it's a developmental process that they have to go through to make sure it's progressive. And you have seen from, and you have second generations and other generations coming up now that understands the power, how government has actually affect your daily life. As you hear constantly in politics, all politics is local. And people are realizing that it's not just the presidential races that is affecting them, because of course you want to vote during the presidential, but the local races as well. And knowing one of the things recently in Broward County, just like people are realizing the judicial races, that that's the only time they're going to find out who this attorney is, because next time they don't even know, as far as you know. So there are certain rules that people start understanding, the school boards, you know, as far as your school board member, how to go about choosing that. So there's a lot of things, but the Haitians now, it's an educational process. So as other business people are more or less educating, and educators are educating folks and letting them know to be part of the system where you live. You cannot just be in a vacuum, or as far as just thinking back of just back home, because where you live, you are being affected. And the only way you're gonna make the changes that some Haitians are realizing now, you're gonna make the changes back home in Haiti, is to participate. First, let's do what you need to do here. And then, collectively, you would be able to help back home.
And so, but what you just said, we know that now they understand better that they are what it means to vote and to participate actively on a local level. And now we have the special election in the city of North Miami, and we have also in the county, we have the first Haitian American commissioner gonna run again. And in Broward, we have one candidate. How many candidates we have in Broward so far?
As far as a Haitian American?
Yes.
Well, right now there's a Haitian American running for school board in Broward, as far as that, you know, that openly that says that he is, you know, as far as Haitian. But what's happening in Broward is not just that, as far as Haitian American, I think more people are getting involved, and preparation is still being made, looking at the numbers, to be able to run in future races. So let's not let this primary be the, so to speak, the measuring rod as far as seeing how progressive it's been. But right now there are still people is going through the changes as far as understanding and being prepared for future elections.
Election. Yes. Now, the primaries are coming up, and what do you see the participation? Even not only the participation, but the tendency of who to vote. Is how they take more attention, taking more attention on the qualification of the candidate?
I think there's a lot more wisdom at play than even 2 years ago in the primaries. As Patrick mentioned, his own role in facilitating civic engagement through leadership among not just young people, but those of us at any age, because civic engagement is most vibrant in the best functioning democracies. And so I like to speak of teaching the conspiracy of democracy. I like to make sure that my students have the opportunity, it's not a requirement, to serve as interns with elected officials and appointed officials, mm-hmm. to get an idea about, How does that work? What do they do? Are they doing what they say they do, although they're operating in a supportive, civic engaged environment? And it's my observation, because the predominance of the some nearly 200 students I teach each of the last semesters happen to be Haitian American, that there's a lot more, not just willingness, but actual engagement, which is then leading to the real issues. If you get a little political campaign thing, brochure, and someone brought it into class in the spring, and I rather enjoyed the fact that they said, you know, somebody wants to quit public support of public stadiums for private money and these other things, but how does that affect me, Dr. Lenaghan? And I would say, that's your question. And you need to identify with whom, which candidate is advancing that. And so I've noticed in the campaigns of at least 11 candidates, I have Haitian American supportive individuals. With regard to the campaigns of individuals who are Haitian American, not only Haitian American, but other individuals who realize these people are supporting issues that affect my daily life. And so there's a synergy between the point you're making and asking the question and then the opportunity to educate those of us who are part of a pluralistic, not majority-minority, Miami-Dade County, as opposed to a majority-minority paradigm that's quickly disappearing in Miami-Dade and Florida and elsewhere as we speak.
And you have the experience in the classroom, which is a more educated voters, and about the general public, Patrick, how you see you going to the churches, what is the reaction?
Well, the general public, as far as even with the churches, you have to train the trainers. You have a lot of religious and spiritual leaders out there that sometimes used to take the position of that we don't get into politics.
Only 10 minutes, the 10 seconds left.
Okay. We don't want to take as far as politics. Politics does not affect us. But now that people start seeing that how politics, so now not just from the pulpit, because legally they cannot say it from the pulpit, but at least letting people know that they have to exercise their rights. So there's more of a push for everybody to get involved in political and making sure they vote.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Unfortunately, we are out of time. I'm Fala. Thanks for watching.